वक्रतुंड महाकाय।
ಇವತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಯುವತಿಯರಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ವಿಶೇಷವಾದ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ವಾಹಿನಿ ಮೂಲಕ ಪರಿಚಯಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಗಾಯತ್ರಿ ಸಂದೀಪ್. ಇವರು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಪುತ್ರಿ. ಲಾಸ್ ವೇಗಸಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆದಂತಹ ಮಿಸ್ಸಸ್ ಗ್ಲೋಬ್ ಪ್ರಶಸ್ತಿ ವಿಜೇತೆ. ಇವರ ಜೀವನದ ಸಾಧನೆಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಯುವತಿಯರು ಪಾಠವನ್ನು ಕಲಿತು ಇವರ ಜೀವನದ ಸಾಧನೆಗಳ ಅಭ್ಯಾಸಿಸಿ ಅವರೂ ಸಹ ತಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದನ್ನು ಅಳವಡಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಸಾಧನೆ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಾರೆಂಬುದು ನಮ್ಮ ಆಶಯ. ನಮ್ಮ ವಾಹಿನಿಗೆ ಸ್ವಾಗತ.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್.
ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ?
ಎವ್ರಿ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಬೋರ್ನ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್ ಇಸ್ ಯುನೀಕ್. ಇಸ್ ಜರ್ನಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ from somewhere. It passes on. In that journey, we feel happiness, sad, we win, we taste success, we take failures. So many emotions, so many things happen in life, and life goes on. Today, the journey of Gayathri, how will you hear from her? Thank you.
Thank you, sir. My journey, I have been born and brought up in Delhi. So basically my education was in Delhi. I did
so
my schooling.
Yes. Base was in Delhi.
Yeah. So schooling was in St. Thomas Convent, and then I joined DTEA. My other education. Later on, after completing 10th, I moved to Bangalore because my father got transferred here to ITI.
Okay.
So there I did my Kendriya Vidyalaya in Malleshwaram. I did my 11th and 12th, and then my graduation is from St. Joseph's. So this is my basic education. Later on, I did my post graduation from Bangalore University. So after that is called MSW.
So moving from Delhi to Bangalore.
Yeah.
And you studied in Kendriya Vidyalaya.
Yeah.
Okay. So CBSE.
Yes.
And initially your mother tongue is?
Tamil. I'm an IR girl.
Tamil.
Yes.
So can you say something about your days in childhood?
Delhi, I can speak very good Hindi. I think I speak more Hindi than Tamil now. So my I have lot of memories there. I stayed in Karol Bagh and then RK Puram. So lot of memories are still there. And I sometimes I do miss Delhi. But now I've got used to Bangalore now. So sometimes if time permits, I go back and live my memories. Yes.
And in your college days,
yes,
in your school days, can you remember most inspiring moments or something, some teachers, some friends, and some incidents which
basically,
you want to share?
Yeah, basically I was very bold.
Yeah.
As a childhood, I used to be bold among all the other girls also.
Okay.
So once our bus didn't come to school, or we missed our bus or something, so I took three or four other my friends, and we walked all the way to home. I saw that everywhere gets dropped home. I walked along. We didn't have any money, nothing. We just walked. We didn't know the direction also so much, but I did it.
Okay.
So I was very bold from my childhood.
She was bold even from her school days. You studied at St. Joseph's?
Yes, I did my industrial relations, economics and sociology in St. Joseph's. So I remember taking part in all the academic activities, cultural activities. So I used to sing, dance, drama. So all that I used to take part in my college days. So I had the liking towards glamour world from the beginning. So it was there in my blood or what I can say. So, but coming from a conservative family, I was not allowed to take part in modeling and all that. But I did my first photo shoot when I was in college.
St. Joseph.
Yes.
Graduation there?
Yes, I did my graduation there. And then I did my post-graduation from Bangalore University called MSW.
MSW. So, social work?
Yes.
Okay. So, your major education happened in Bangalore?
Yes.
Then got qualified. Then you moved on. Did you, in that days, there was a concept of campus recruitment and all like that?
Yeah. For MSW, there was not a campus recruitment.
Okay.
But I applied on my own since I was interested in PR kind of a job and HR.
Yeah.
So I joined Taj Group.
Taj Group.
Yes.
So your initial.
My first job was at Taj Group. Yes. And so then I worked for many software companies and then a company called Makino, a Japanese company. I worked with them for nearly 5 years. And then I also have experience with medical transcription
medical
company
transcription.
Also.
So viewers, now a beautiful journey has just started.
In India, the success of a girl child even today depends upon their parents' attitude. Parents' attitude towards the girl child's education in the initial stages makes that girl a successful woman. Today, I want to know, Gayathri,
yes,
the role of your parents in your today's achievements. Even today in India, a girl's success largely depends upon their parents' attitude towards girl child. Even today, discrimination happens for girl children. The initial support a girl receives from her parents plays an important role in their future. Gayathri, the role of your parents in your success?
My parents have been always been supportive to me. My father has never discriminated. We were two sisters.
Mm-hmm.
Both of us have got equal education,
mm-hmm,
and he never stopped us from doing anything, saying that you are a girl, you cannot do this and all that. So he has been always supportive. Even my mom.
Your dad's name and your mother's name?
Yeah, my dad's name is Mr. Satyamurthy. Mom's name is Shyamala.
Shyamala. Satyamurthy, what was he working?
He was working with PNG in finance.
Finance, okay.
And in Delhi, mm-hmm, and then later on we got transferred to Bangalore in ITI.
What aspects till today you remember about your mom and dad, which you yourself is teaching next generation?
Yeah, my father was very disciplined,
uh-huh,
and he was very clear about time management.
Uh-huh.
So he used to, if we say 3:30 means we have to be there by 3:30.
Mm-hmm.
So he never used to like people coming late and all that.
Uh-huh.
So I think I imbibed that today also.
Mm-hmm.
When I say time, the same time I'll be there. If I tell a particular time.
So
I don't like going late for
punctuality
anything.
Punctuality has taught you, which
yeah,
till today you...
Yeah, I follow that.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't like making others wait or
mm-hmm
whatever. Because time is precious.
Uh-huh.
So we have to respect time.
Time.
To come up in life.
That was the most important aspect which your dad
yeah
taught
yeah
you. And in those days,
yeah,
your mom?
My mom was a housewife only, but
uh-huh
she was very hard working,
mm-hmm,
and she taught us that anything we have to be a perfectionist. She
mm-hmm
was a perfectionist. In whatever she did,
mm-hmm,
she used to put her soul
mm
and do it. So I learned that from her.
From your mom.
Like she was always, this is not correct means she will say this is not correct. You have to do it again.
Again.
She won't leave us till we do it properly.
Perfectly.
Yeah.
So, who was your parents' support for your education and all?
Yeah, they both were very supportive. Huh. Even when I finished my graduation, they said you should go further and study. Mm-hmm. I wanted to take part in IAS examination.
Civil service examination.
Yeah, I tried that also. I did so many like.
For all.
They never stopped us.
They never stopped you.
Yeah.
They encouraged you at every step.
Yeah.
So.
Be it education, singing, dancing, everything, they used to support us.
So, discipline and time management are the skills she has learned from her father. From her mother, Gayathri has learned to be a perfectionist. So, these three things she remembers till today about her parents. And she wants that to pass on to her next generation. So, your parents initially were very supportive. And you told, even after completing your graduation, they told, work.
Yes.
So, their role was very, very important. Gayathri.
Yes.
In every human being life, there comes a stage where the influence of friends increases.
Yes.
We are influenced by our friends in a negative way as well as in a positive way. There are years in our life where company of friends plays an important role. If at that stage wrong friendships, wrong influences will spoil life. So at that stage in your teenage years, in your initial years, where there is a sort of rebellion in every human being.
Yeah,
oh,
that's true.
So we want to prove that we are free from our school days, from our parents. So we are getting independent. At that stage, more friends influence starts. So the friends who influenced, how was your friends influence in your success?
Yeah, friends play a very important role in anybody's life. Mm-hmm. We cannot think alike without friends.
Mm-hmm.
We can share with them happiness, sorrow, whatever. So friends, I cannot think a life without friends.
Mm-hmm.
They are like God to us sometimes. Yeah. Because we can share anything we are going through with them.
Mm-hmm.
So of course, in my life also, there have been a lot of ups and downs and all that. So my friends have always been there as a support.
Okay.
So I have learned a lot from my friends and moved forward in my life.
In today's generation, having online friends, do you want to say anything about for today's girls, how to choose friends in their teenage years, maybe in their early years? And
actually, there's no particular guidelines where we can give it. It's up to your judgment.
How you are.
Then select your friends.
You cannot trust
anyone. That's one thing they should remember.
Yeah.
They cannot trust anyone blindfoldedly. That, okay, she is good, I can go with her or whatever. We have to be very judgmental.
This question I asked because friendship requests come on Facebook, they accept it.
Correct.
And WhatsApp, they do friendship.
Yeah.
And they share their information.
Yeah,
and like
especially personal information, we have to be very careful before sharing.
Mm, especially for girls. That's why.
And even the pictures.
Pictures.
Yeah, we have to be very careful before sharing it.
So
you have to be very judgmental about a person and then going ahead and doing it.
So in your college days and in your teenage years, you had a very good friendship.
Yes.
Very good company.
I had a very good company and friends.
Now, any incident you want to share in your college days? Like you participated in some drama, events, extracurricular activities. You want to recall that?
No, like always I have a very good set of friends, but I don't have anybody who has been like very bad to me in my life. Mm-hmm. Always all my friends have been very good.
Very supportive.
Yes. So it's not that, but sometimes yes, you do get hurt.
Uh-huh.
So that time I've learned some things in my life. Mm-hmm. It's like that. Plus and minus.
Okay. Friendship has played its role.
Yeah.
In some way or the other.
And I'm a very social person, so I can't think a life without friends.
Friends. Okay.
So I need friends 24/7.
So, you're
that
a
is
very
my
friendly
kind
person,
of,
a social kind of a person.
Yeah.
So, friends have played a very positive role in our life. Runanubandha rupena pati patni sutalaya. Gayathri.
Yes.
according to this Hindu shloka, to get a good wife, a good husband, a good house, a good children, it all depends on our karma. It's runa. So, Gayathri, your husband, his role in your life, in your success.
My husband's name is Sandeep. He is a pediatrician.
Uh-huh.
And we met through another friend. Ours was a love marriage.
Uh-huh.
So I am an Iyer, he's a Mangalorean.
Okay.
So we are married now for 18 years.
18 years. Uh-huh.
So it looks like a long time, but I still feel that we are newly married even now. Because he has been always been supportive of whatever I do in my life. He has never stopped me from saying that you cannot work or you cannot do this, you cannot do that. So it's understanding between us that I have come up so much.
When you got married, you were working?
Yeah, I was working.
Okay.
Yeah, so I continued working even after marriage. For nearly, I worked for 15 years.
15 years.
Yes. So I continued my working job. Yes. So there was never a restriction that I cannot work after marriage and all that. So he's been very supportive.
Very supportive.
So even my now which I took part in beauty contest. So he was, he's the one who said, why don't you go and try it? I was skeptical first that whether I'd be able to do it or not. But he said, no, you go and live your dreams. So that's where my journey started, because of his support.
You got married in the initial days.
Yeah.
He was a pediatrician. He was also working, and you were also working.
Yeah.
So how did you manage that initial days? Both were working.
Yeah.
Huh? Initial days, and maybe till you had a child. After that, everything changes.
Yes, that's true. Initially, we had to struggle a lot because we had to start from a scratch. And support was little less from the family side, so we had to do on our own. So I also used to work from 9 to long hours. Till late nights, and he also used to work along us, and somehow we managed. And today I'm happy that we bought a house with whatever our earnings and all that. So I'm very happy about it.
And you had a kid.
Yeah.
After having a kid, again, as you told, again we were working at this same time.
Yeah.
And he was also working.
Yeah.
So how was he supporting managing your kid?
Initially it was a little difficult because then my mom helped me a lot.
Okay.
So I was able to manage. Then I quit after 2 years.
2 years.
After he was born.
I was born.
Yeah. So I wanted to give my full attention to my child.
So, give me your heartfelt word for Sandeep.
Very supportive, understanding and loving.
Loving.
Yes. That's so what describes him. And very truthful.
Truthful.
Yeah, so, and very simple person.
So
I can go on and on.
the concept of Ardhanarishvara, where husband and a wife share everything equally. Here in your life,
example.
Sandeep and Gayathri have shared everything equally. Joys,
sorrows,
struggles,
ups and downs,
success, everything. Yes. And you have moved on and achieved so much today.
Today, yes.
First dog was a Taj getaway. First time you were working. How was that?
Anybody, I think, first time when they get a job, they're so like they feel top of the world. So there was the same experience for me also. I felt very, very happy about it. I came and shared the news with my parents. That time I was not married, so I was very, very happy that day. I came and when I got my letter in my hand, appointment letter, that was one of my happiest moments because your first job, it is like memory forever. So I was very, very, very happy on that day. And later on, I started working. There are plus and minus in any job. So there were late nights, shifts were there, so all that. So it was initial some struggles were there. But I was very happy that I was working on my own.
For a girl, how much it is important to be financially independent?
A woman should be very independent because you don't know how the life will take a turn in your, in the any moment. So tomorrow, suppose she loses her spouse, so what she will do? So she needs to be independent.
Independent.
Yeah.
So financial independence is very, very important. Important.
And education also.
Education.
So independence and education go together.
Go together.
Yeah.
After working for a few years in Taj,
yeah,
you shifted to human resource. Can yeah. you tell me the
Actually,
companies you worked?
Yeah, I work for a company called Makino. It's a Japanese company. So I was in charge of admin. So overall, I worked for 5 years. So I traveled also to Japan and Singapore that time.
Okay.
Yeah. So it was a very nice experience. It's a memorable experience for
memorable experiences for me.
Yeah.
So working in HR department, what are skills you learned there?
HR department, you meet a lot of all kinds of people, and you have to be very sure when you take a candidate in, when you interview a candidate, you should know whether he is fitting for the job or not. So a lot of responsibility is on you. So it is a lot of responsibility which we have to be very careful in taking a candidate.
Okay.
So, but it was very nice, like I made new friends, and it was like every day you meet a different kind of a person. And people used to come and share their problems with us. My family is going through this. I need more salary and all those kind of things.
Yeah.
Then ladies coming and sharing their personal problems. Sometimes they used to tell about their husbands not being good and all that. So it's a.
How many years did you work in HR?
I think totally 7 years.
7 years.
Yeah.
So almost after the graduation, you worked for more than 10 years
yeah.
together
yeah.
from Taj and
yes,
you.
Yes, yeah.
So, a decade of working as a woman, what is the most important aspect you have learned?
Important sense, I am very happy that I was financially independent. That gave me a lot of confidence in life.
Okay.
Even today, I feel that women should work. If possible, if she is educated, and she should go out and work.
Work.
And use her talent.
Talent.
Yeah.
From her, you can learn that for 10 long years, she has been a working woman. And the one word she told flat out, financial independence. A girl should have financial independence, she should work, and also about education. Education and financial independence for girls is the most important aspect which Gayathri has told to all of us. Gayathri, you are a trained Carnatic classical singer. So, can you share something about your passion for music?
My family is full of people who are talented for singing. My mom, my aunts. My uncle, they all sing. So it has been there from the childhood. I learned when I was 6 years.
6 years. Oh.
So I've been learning till then, till I finished my graduation in Carnatic music.
Okay.
So my mom has been behind this.
Oh, so mom.
She's a very good singer.
Singer. So from her.
Her island.
Island.
Yeah, yeah.
Music in your hectic schedule, how it has helped you?
It relaxes my mind sometimes, you know, like when you are depressed, when you are sad, when you listen to music, it peps you up.
Okay.
So that's what I believe, that music is soul therapy.
Soul therapy, okay. And I also know you are a Bharatanatyam dancer.
Yeah. Bharatanatyam, I couldn't pursue much because of my that time. But I love dancing, any form.
Any form.
Yeah. So anywhere, anytime, I can dance.
Anytime, dance. You love dance.
Yeah, it's my passion. Always music and dance.
Music and dance is your passion.
Yeah.
Okay. And in this, means you are competing in beauty contest,
yeah.
And you have a kid to take care of,
yeah.
home, and in spite of all this, if you again get a chance, would you learn Bharatanatyam?
Even now I want to learn Carnatic. I want to continue further.
Further?
Yeah, but I've learned some bhajans and all that.
Bhajans and kirtans.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So,
I believe in
Sai.
So I learn some Sai bhajans.
Sai bhajans. Can you sing one Sai bhajan for our audience? Can you sing a few lines for our audience?
Yeah, sure. Vagishwari Vani Saraswati Vagishwari Vani Saraswati Varadayaki Vanajaba Vasaki Vagishwari Vani Saraswati Varadayaki Vanajaba Vasaki Vagishwari.
Today, our audience are going to discover not only she is beautiful, her voice is also very beautiful.
And thank you, sir.
Your singing was wonderful.
Thank you.
Those who respect time, time respects them. As a working woman, as a mother, as a wife, there are so many roles to play. You have to take care of your family as well as your work. So, how did you give time for both? How did you manage both?
Initially, it was very difficult. Because my kid was small, I had to be with him always.
Mm-hmm.
Later on, I started working when he was around 12 years.
Uh-huh.
So, later on, I used to manage somehow, give importance to him also and my work also.
Uh-huh.
Because you have families first for me, always. Uh-huh. So, first I used to finish all my work at home,
mm-hmm.
and then go out for my other activities. It has always been like that. And of course, my husband was there to support me. So, he helped me to balance both.
So, his role was very important.
Yeah.
What do you say for certain people, which I usually hear nowadays?
Yeah.
More importance to work, neglecting the family life. Or sometimes giving up the work altogether and concentrating on family life. Means it is their choice. But this extremes really a girl needs to do, or she can manage both.
Yeah,
what are any few tips you can give for girls?
Yeah, I think each individual has their own opinions about this.
Mm-hmm.
Some girls feel that they should take care of family.
Mm-hmm.
That is their priority. And even the family support is important in this
That's
case.
The way.
Sometimes a family don't like a girl going out and working.
Mm.
So that is also matters actually. Some
mm-hmm.
girls want to work, they cannot work.
Mm.
So then sometimes I feel bad for that because we need to be more open nowadays. We have to support a girl. If she is career-oriented and all that, we need to support. And husband's role comes very important
very
here.
Very important.
More than anybody else. Because without his support, she cannot do anything after marriage.
After marriage.
Because if his family says no, and husband is supportive about her, she can go ahead and do it.
Do it.
Yeah.
So, you were able to give time for both.
Yeah.
And as I see, you are quite...
able to do that. Because son is in an important, now he's in 9th standard and he needs my attention also. So I try to balance both.
Balance. So time management skills.
Very, because I learned from my dad.
Dad.
And
that's what I wanted to say. That has.
And discipline also.
That
yes.
has helped you.
Yes,
to
helped
balance
me today.
Both family and work.
So I give importance to both.
Both family.
And
as
if
well.
I cannot do it, I'll tell very clearly I cannot do it. I don't want to promise somebody and then I cannot do it.
Uh-huh.
I will tell them very clearly that I'm held up with my family things. So I cannot do it. It's like that for me.
Okay.
I won't promise something which is not plausible from my side. So
today what happens,
mm-hmm.
what I initially see is that we are living in a virtual world.
Yeah.
And time itself has become virtual.
Yes.
So, most of them spend most of the time on online, Facebook, WhatsApp, internet, and all those things.
Yeah.
And what is the most important aspect of time in your life?
I also feel sometimes that I am spending too much of time on social media,
mm-hmm.
but because my job involves that,
mm-hmm.
because I am in that kind of a limelight situation now, so I need to spend my time on social media, but I think it should not affect your family and your health also. So sometimes they get too much into that, so it helps affects you mentally also. So I think we should try to balance somehow. And don't get too much involved in the social media and all that. We need to draw a line somewhere. For yourself, for your good, your family and everything, you need to draw a line. You cannot be 24 hours on social media and all that, yes.
Sometimes on social media, you get criticisms.
Yeah.
How do you handle that?
I used to feel very, very bad earlier. Because there are a lot of... sometimes people used to say that you're not doing okay, this is not correct, that's not correct. But now I'm able to face it. I'm able to take it as challenge. And do better.
Do better.
Yeah.
Oh, today what
so criticism is required in your life.
It has made you more stronger.
More strong.
So what happens nowadays?
Yeah.
They say one photograph, put it on Facebook.
Yeah.
The next day, the most important thing somebody wants to know, it's a boy or girl, how many likes she got?
Yeah. It's kind of too much of pressure on all those things. I think we should not bother for all those things. We should just do something what you feel like doing, and if it's helping you in some way, you should go ahead and post it. But social media is also for whatever about your family and all that. It's not only for this likes and other things, not so important.
It has actually...
It brings the world closer. Yes. I met a lot of my friends through Facebook. So it has helped me a lot of ways. And today I'm interconnected because of, you came to know me because through, I think, social media.
Social media only.
So it has helped me also.
Take
there are plus and minus in everything.
So concentrate.
We have to
concentrate
take
on
the positive side and leave the negative side.
Okay. So time management and everything you should learn from her. She has managed her family as well work in a wonderful way. And this is the most important lesson, Gayathri, you are told for today's girls.
Yes, thank you.
Gayathri, as a mother, how you give her time to kid? This question arises because you are a working woman and you are also participating in beauty contest and your son has grown up. Now he's in teenage years. Almost he's reaching his teenage
teenage years.
So, do you attend parents-teachers meeting, school day functions, everything? What kind of time you give your kid?
I think motherhood is the biggest change in one's woman's life.
Mm-hmm.
Because after he was born, like everything changed for me.
Mm-hmm.
All my attention was only for him.
Mm.
So we have to give love and support to your child every time, every day.
Mm.
So that's very important for me as an individual.
Mm.
So I try to spend as much time as possible with him.
Mm.
So I try to balance my time. If I have to go out, I'll see that he is comfortable at home and then go out.
Okay.
And especially when he comes from school, I'm always there.
Okay.
So I'll tell people I can't come that time. So I will tell them that either you reschedule some other time and all that. So I'm always there for him, my son. And
motherhood.
Yeah.
It has impacted you very much.
Yeah. Very much. It's because it has changed one's life because your attention altogether is on your son or daughter, whatever it is. So it is totally changes your life.
What is your son's?
They become very important.
Your son's name?
Arnav.
What is he studying?
He is in 9th in Bishop Cotton's.
So next year is going to be
board exams. I'm more worried than him.
Oh.
I'm more tense than him, but I know he's doing very well.
Very well.
He's he has got a lot of prizes academically.
Okay.
He stood first for past 3-4 years. So I'm very happy about it. It's a proud moment for me more than getting a crown.
Yeah. Your son scoring very good marks. It was more important.
Happy moment for me. Winning a crown for me. It was like that.
Like that. So every parent will have a dream.
Yeah.
What dreams?
For my child, I have given all his. I left it to him, like whatever he wants to become, I'm there to support him.
You are great to support him.
Yeah. So let him pursue his dreams. I'm always there for him. It's like that for me.
Whatever he wants in life,
yeah,
he can go after that.
Yeah.
You'll be always there for his support.
Yes. And only advice I give him that he should not fall into bad company.
Uh-huh.
And he should not waste his time in unnecessary things like being on TV or gadgets. I also control that.
Mm.
So I don't want him to. I want him to go out and play. So he also plays football, my child. So I want him to go out and play. than being at home.
This a very important question I want to ask. This aspect. Mm. Today, most of the kids, they are busy in online games.
Yeah.
And what I am saying is that a few years back, go out, play in the ground. There, if you fall, there is the friends used to come and pick you up, put that sand or something. Then we were again going to start play.
Yeah.
Here, there was like a friendship used to develop and fall, win. We were exposed to sun.
Yeah.
We used to play in rain.
Same.
All those things were there. Now, everything is gone.
Changed.
And this aspect is very important what you brought up now.
And I hardly see any open space for children today.
Children today.
It's only malls. I think every community should have a playing space for the kids. Even every apartment, now they are developing new space to play. Otherwise, there's no place for them to play.
You told you are happy to see your son play football.
Yeah, yeah. Very happy to see that.
Means outdoor games.
Yeah.
Games. How it will help?
Very, very important for health-wise.
Uh-huh.
Even for the mind stimulation.
Mm-hmm.
Games are very important.
Very important.
So they should go out and play more than playing the gadgets.
They should
go out and explore new things. Nowadays there's so many bungee jumping. There's so many things that they can go and explore. And they can also go for trekking. There's so many things, and they should be with the nature. That's
so
what my idea is.
My idea is.
Yeah.
So you want your kid to be more with nature than with gadgets.
Yeah, very much.
Very much.
So I always keep telling him, so even that I keep a watch, that he is not too much into mobile or anything. Of course, I've bought a mobile for him for some reason, but I don't want him to be on mobile 24 hours.
24 hours. Kids should be with nature.
Yeah, with the nature, yes.
But play outdoor games.
Yeah.
This is the most important aspect which I too emphasize the most. Because if the kids go and play outside, if the kids are with nature, they are close to earth. When they are close to earth, they learn more.
Yes. Mother Earth.
Yeah. Mother Earth.
Yes.
Gayathri.
Yeah.
You did a lot of social work. How did you start?
Since I've done my MSW, that was post-graduation social work.
Mm-hmm.
From there it started for me, my love for social work. Of course, I did personalization in personal management, specialization in personal management. But social work, we went to villages and all that time when I was doing my post-graduation.
When you were doing your MSW, there were camps like that.
Yeah, we used to go to the camps, help the villagers. So we stayed in a village also. I don't remember the village name.
It was Indandar or Bangalore.
Yes,
Bangalore.
So outskirts of Bangalore.
So that was your first experience of
a social work, proper social work.
And rural life, first time?
Yeah, first time.
Rural life.
Yeah.
Okay.
We stayed like overnight in some villager's house also.
Okay.
Overnight we stayed. We had a lot of fun.
So your social work began from there.
Yeah, from there I had in my mind that I should do social work. Then I got involved in HR, so I left social work a little behind. But later on today it has come back to me that I should give back to the society, the social work.
Mm.
Because everybody needs something, that we need to help them out in our life. So that is very important for me.
Mm.
If my capacity, I should go and help somebody.
Mm.
So that is always there for me, that important for me that I...
You visited a few orphanages.
Orphanages and all.
Gayathri, you used to visit orphanages and all.
Yeah.
Tell me about that experience.
I have love for the children, so that is my priority.
Mm-hmm.
I can do something for the children.
Uh-huh.
So I near my house there's Seva Sadhan.
Seva Sadhan.
Yeah.
Malayalam 13th class.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So I go there whenever time permits, and also on my birthday or my son's birthday or spouse's birthday, we go there and spend some time with the children. That gives me more happiness. It's not that only material thing we have to give the children.
Uh-huh.
We have to give our love because they don't have parents.
Yes.
So they need our love, our compassion.
Compassion.
So that is very important.
Uh-huh.
So people think social service only give you materialist thing. It's not that.
It's also
spending time
with them,
sharing our love, compassion for them.
Mm-hmm.
It's very important. And
so
that gives more happiness.
More happiness too.
Yeah.
When you visit an orphanage, when you interact with those kids, the experience which you feel.
That is like above the world.
Yeah.
I feel very happy. And they also, they come and hug you. Mm-hmm. They hold your hand. When some kids come and sit on me also. They don't feel that we are outsiders. They interact so well.
That motherly love comes.
Yeah, comes automatically.
Automatically.
So they feel so nice about it. And I also feel so happy that day.
Uh-huh.
That it's like a kind of, the happiness we cannot explain.
Uh-huh.
It is really very, very nice.
Very nice experience
yeah.
you are having there.
Yeah.
So
and even the kids feel so good that somebody has come to share their happiness, sorrow, whatever.
So, the love when you share with those kids, it magnifies, it doubles,
yeah.
and you get a lot of peace,
yes.
calmness.
Yeah. And even I want to imbibe to my son
uh-huh.
that he should. Continue social service when he grows up also. So I take for his birthday also I take him there and cut a cake there or something
mm-hmm.
so that he also feels importance of that social work is so important in our life.
You take your son for his birthday there?
Yeah, his birthday also I want him to celebrate there.
Okay.
Later on he can be with his friend, that is a different
That's
thing.
Different.
But he should also know that how some people are so well we are so well off in life and some people are not so privileged.
Ground realities of life you want to teach your son.
Yeah.
Ground realities.
Yeah. So that tomorrow he should not feel that this is the only world.
Yeah.
There's a world outside.
Outside. This is
that's
wonderful
thing.
Because
yeah.
very. I have did so many. I interact with so many persons and all. And I think first time I am hearing that a mother wants to teach the ground realities to his kid. Wonderful work you are going there, Gayathri. Wonderful.
Because they won't know the reality of life.
Yeah.
They think only this is gadgets, going to nice restaurant, eating nice food, that is the life. It is not so.
So
they have to learn, see how the other kids are in the society, so that tomorrow they also give back to them something. So when he grows up, I want him to continue this.
Continue this. And your work with Kidwai Hospital Cancer Kids.
Oh, that was really, really good. So,
cancer
is something we all dread. And when you hear the word cancer, they are so happy and so joyful. They don't know that they're suffering from cancer. We have to learn from them. Like, life is like so short, but still they are so happy with that one moment or whatever.
When you were visited, how many?
I think 2 months back.
2 months back.
There was an event also.
Okay.
And plus, if whenever time permits, I go on my own and spend some time with them.
Cancer means even
it's a dreaded word.
Today, that word shake, and especially if you see a kid having cancer.
It's really, really, yeah.
And there are so many questions come,
yeah.
like what mistake has done, bad habits, or means maybe. We all know scientifically it is through genes and when you interact with those kids,
so innocent,
the emotions you feel.
And they don't feel they are suffering from anything, they are just normal.
Normal.
We don't, only when they have shaven their hair, like hair is not there, we know they are suffering, otherwise they look like a normal child.
No. So, even today, the cancer is being looked as a dreaded disease.
Yeah.
You meet those cancer kids, what kind of emotions?
I was crying when I met 3 or 4 people. I was really in tears. But they didn't show anything, emotions. They were so, they were on their own. They were happy. They came and hugged me. They feel so nice when somebody goes and asks them. Because they're in that hospital, right? So they feel so, in the four walls, they feel so bad. Because they can't lead a normal child's life. How a child, they can go out and play. They wish they could make friends outside. They have so many ambitions inside them. But they cannot do all that. As a normal child. So when we go and talk to them, they feel so happy that somebody has come to ask for me. And they share their joy, sorrow, everything.
Okay.
So it's very emotional for me when I go there.
So you want to do something for them?
Yeah, I think in future I will do. Whatever, not financially, at least spend time with them. I'll go at least once in 2 months or whenever time permits. I think I'll go do that.
And I was doing research about you and all. And Mrs. Globe and Mrs. India, those were actually highlight for me.
Correct.
But after doing this segment of interview, they are not the highlight for me.
Yeah.
You have done tremendous work, especially two things: going to cancer kids, spending time with them, going to orphanages, spending time with them. These both things will be the most highlight of this interview, because people talk a lot.
Yeah, that's true.
They don't do it.
And we should do it full-heartedly. We cannot fake it, whatever. Because I feel for the kids, for the children who are suffering from this disease. So I think I should spend time with them whenever I can. And that gives more happiness than anything in the world. Than going on a world tour or whatever, I think.
This gives you more happiness.
Yeah, that's true.
You can see her.
Yeah, I'm still emotional about it. Yeah.
Mrs. Globe, Mrs. India, her outer beauty is famous, but today you can see her heart beats for orphan kids, her heart beats for cancer affected kids. And I always say, if our inner soul is good, if our inner feelings are good, it will reflect on our face. We glow. And you're glowing. Because you have that good heart, you have that good soul. So it has added a beauty to your
charm, yes.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir, for saying those words. It really means a lot to me.
Okay.
Thank you.
Health and fitness are the most important aspects of human life.
Yeah.
We may be rich, poor, anything.
Health
is most important. How do you maintain your health, and what is your fitness regime?
Health is wealth, as we know. So it's very important that to be fit, and especially when you are in this line, you need to be more fit. So earlier I had put on a lot of weight when after my son was born. So I was not at all conscious about myself. I was just eating whatever possible, whatever coming in my way and all that. So later on I realized how important it is. Once I got into this line, I had to lose some 8 to 9 kgs and all that. From there on, till today, I see what I eat. I think before what I eat. And exercise is very important.
Very important.
So I make it a habit to go and do exercise every day.
Every day.
Except for Sundays.
Sundays.
So that is gym.
So food.
Yeah, food is very important. They say 80% is food. Or even 90% we can
Aharam
say.
Amritam Visham.
So we have to watch what we are eating. I'm not saying you have to stop completely anything like that. But eat healthy most of the time.
So
and be conscious what you eat.
You consume a lot of fruits, vegetables like
fruits, that? Fruits, vegetables, and of course, drink a lot of water.
Drink a lot of
important.
Water.
That's also very important. So I try to keep drinking a lot of water every time. And avoid oily foods.
Oily food.
Yeah. And sweets, of course.
Sweets. So your fitness regime includes going to gym.
Yeah.
Having a balanced diet.
Diet.
So weekly 6 days.
Yeah.
So
at least I go, and I also like dancing, as I said earlier. So I do Zumba whenever possible.
Yeah.
And then I like nature.
Nature.
So I go to Sankey Park near
Sankey
my
Park.
House.
Yeah.
So I because sometimes it gets boring to go to gym every day. And you get bored. So I think any kind of exercise is good. Like suppose you are a sports person, you can go out and play. Suppose you are you like cycling, you can do cycling.
Okay.
You like swimming, you can do swimming. It's not that you have to go to gym every day.
Today I read the newspaper.
Yeah.
India is turning out to be the diabetes capital of the whole world.
Yeah. So
exercise,
I think it's high time we watch what we are doing about our health.
So
it can be anything. I think people think this exercise means only gym.
A simple
it's not
walk,
that. It's a walk. It can be swimming. It can be aerobics. It can be dance. Anything it can be. It's not that you have to go to gym 24/7 or whatever. You can do whatever you like, because it should not be, and even yoga nowadays,
yoga
world is recognizing yoga, which is from our India. So you have to follow some kind of 20 minutes, I think, maximum. in your life.
Yeah. It helps you a lot.
Lot. And the day I don't do exercise, I feel more tired.
Tired.
Then okay. The day I do it. So you can feel the change when you start doing it.
As habits, people say the bad habits, once we cultivate, it's very difficult to leave.
Exercise,
same with good habits.
Yeah.
Once we cultivate it,
you cannot leave it.
Leave it.
Yeah, it becomes a part of you.
Oh, part of life.
So we have to give importance to our health today, because of the kind of disease we are seeing nowadays, new disease, new
pollution,
and the pollution and all that. So we have to keep ourselves somehow fit and healthy.
Healthy. So it depends 80% on food.
Yeah.
And 20% on your physical regime.
Yeah.
That's what Gayathri wants to say.
Yeah.
Gayathri. Role of education in a girl's life. How important it is, you feel. Even today there is discrimination when it comes to girl
education,
child.
Yeah.
Male children educated, male children earning. So it has decreased a lot, but still it is there. So what do you feel the most important thing about education among girls?
Education as such is very important, maybe be it a boy or a girl, it's very important in everybody's life. I feel they should at least get the basic education.
Uh-huh.
And government should see to that they get basic education. I've seen how many child labor, instead of going to school, they are doing some child labor.
Uh-huh.
I've seen around me. I feel so bad. Of course, there are kids who don't want to study, that's also there. But I think the parents' responsibility first, to see the child is doing at least basic.
Basic education.
Primary. I think government schools are there now. Uh-huh. They give free education and all that. And especially when it comes to girls, they say, oh, girls need not be educated because anyway they're going to get married. They don't have to get educated. That's a very wrong perception. If you educate a girl, it's like educating a society. It's equal to educating a society.
Yeah.
And for the nation's development, I think girls' education is more important in today's world. And
one girl educated means entire family is
educated. That's what the saying goes, right? So I believe in that. So girls' education is very, very, very important. At least the basic education, she should have it.
See, the irony of our culture. The education goddess, Saraswati, she is a woman.
Woman, yeah.
And today, stopping the
girls from getting educated. Yes. That is very wrong.
Very wrong.
So I think, and even as an individual, we can ask, we can do our bit is like, I ask my maid, like whether her daughter is going to school. And I even help her whenever possible. Maybe paying little fees or whatever for books. My son's books will be lying, which is not used. So I try to give to her so that her child can write. Diaries and all that. I try my best to help them in whichever way possible to educate.
Educate.
So I think we all should do that. Whichever way possible, we should see that even our maids coming to your house and ask them whether they have any problem educating their child and help them out.
Gayathri, when
starts from the house.
When I speak to you, ask you questions.
Yeah.
I don't know. The world has seen you as Mrs. Globe, Mrs. India. But during the course of my interview, very, very small things which you had done. Like, this is very simple.
Yeah.
What you told.
I think anybody can do that.
But nobody will have that patience to do. And you
see,
are doing
I see my son's books lying waste.
Yeah.
So they can help, ask them to give to their maids or whatever.
Yeah.
Or even some storybooks.
Storybook.
They will read and throw it.
So
instead of that, I give to my maids. So let them read. So
small things,
yeah, in the ocean, drop in the ocean.
What happens now? Yeah. I want to just tell a small thing here.
Yeah.
In Ramayana, when the bridge building was going on, the monkey god, everybody were lifting big, big stones and putting in the
ocean. Yeah.
And Ram Setu was being built.
Yeah.
And there was a squirrel. He can't lift big stones and all. So what he wanted to do now? He used to roll on this hand and go and again roll on the ocean for a stone and come back. And all the monkeys started laughing and at him. But she was upset. And Rama never appreciated the monkeys for building a bridge.
But he appreciated this.
When a bridge was completed, the first animal, the first thing he touched was them. He did this like that. So the three marks on its body is considered to be blessings. Every small work when we do in our culture, we say it as alilu seve.
Okay.
Alilu seve. We always, you do anything big, we always say alilu seve.
Okay.
So
we should we should try to do whatever capacity we can do. We have to do it.
So
maybe it's small thing, but we should think how it's useful to the other person.
Yeah. So you are doing your alilu seve for cancer kids, as well as orphanage, and
indirectly
in education. Small aspects make a big change.
Yeah.
So girls' education is
must.
Every parent should educate their girls.
And even your mates, you have to tell them. They feel, okay, girls, why they have to go to school? Even they feel. But we have to tell them, no, tomorrow they can also work. They can stand on their own feet instead of being under her husband, like being dependent on husband.
Okay.
So they should also get knowledge about this.
So, see,
we can do a small, we can talk to them and share our experience with them. So they will also know that how important it is to
education,
to educate their child, girl child.
Small aspects add big dimensions to life.
That's true.
Today, when I speaking to her, I myself am learning this. You have won Mrs. Globe, Mrs. India, and so many other beauty contests. How did this journey begin?
It started with Mrs. Karnataka,
2016.
So, I was asked to participate in Mrs. Karnataka. So, from there, at that time I was not at all into beauty or anything. I was just an ordinary person, an ordinary girl. But since I was interested in glamour and other things, I said, why not do it? So I took it as a challenge. So I had to lose weight, look good, prepare. There were many rounds, like talent round, personality round, walking the ramp, talking, personality interview and all that. So I had to take it as a challenge and prepare for it. So it was a changing, turning point of my life, I can say.
Means 2 years back.
Yeah.
And Arna was how much year old then?
At that time he was around 12.
12?
Yeah.
So after motherhood of 12 years, you went to beauty contest.
Yeah.
So how was the preparation? Hurdles?
Challenges? A lot of hurdles, like because I had put on weight.
Uh-huh.
I don't know how to face a camera. I don't know how to talk. And we have to prepare for everything ourselves. There's nobody there to help you out. We have to think about your costumes, your makeup, your hair, everything. So it was a big challenge for me that time. But I took it as a challenge and went ahead and did the Mrs. Karnataka.
So. You're a mother, you're a wife. In spite of that busy schedule, and you yourself, you were telling, you have put on weight.
Yeah.
So when you decided to participate in Mrs. World, the first decision you took?
Because I thought, why not, because I was always interested in modeling from my childhood, no? So this came as this thing for me, a kind of glamour, this thing, quotient was there. So I said, why not take it as a this thing, challenge, and let me go ahead and do it. So I just took a decision overnight.
It was an overnight decision?
Yeah, I said, okay, I'll do it.
Uh-huh.
It was there in my mind, should I do or not do, but I said, why, I have to do this, because opportunity just comes once.
Once in
a while. So you should not lose it. That's what my mantra is. So just go ahead and I did
it. You tell our audience, Gayathri, tell me the beauty contest you have won till today.
Mrs. Karnataka, I came in top 5. And then from there my journey went
Mrs.
to...
Mrs. Karnataka 2016?
Yeah. From there I had to... I got an opportunity to go to Mrs. India Beauty Queen, MIBQ. So that was in August.
Yeah?
So I went to Delhi. So there I came as a first runner-up. So, and then Mrs. Globe happened this year.
This year.
June 2017.
Where
to Vegas. Vegas. In US.
US.
Yeah.
Okay. So, three beauty contests.
Yeah.
2016 you started, and just 2017 is going on. And she started after 12 years of motherhood. She again started, and three contests at global level within 1 year.
Yes,
so
yeah.
How do you feel now?
It's a really proud feeling today because people recognize you today. Earlier, nobody knew who was Gayathri Sandeep.
Uh-huh.
But today, they know my name and I'm really happy for that. And it's also God's blessings, I should say, that I'm what I've achieved today. It's His blessing too.
So, when you won the beauty contest in Delhi, you were runner-up there.
Yeah.
And you were Mrs. Globe at Vegas. So, tell me, how was the feeling?
Experience.
Yeah, experience.
At international level, it was different. State level is different. Uh-huh. And international level is
you
different.
You have participated in three.
All the levels.
Yeah.
So it is
state, national,
international.
International.
So it is all different kind of experience, each level.
Mm-hmm.
Because what they expect from us is different.
Mm-hmm.
The audience are different.
Mm-hmm.
And the rounds are different.
Mm.
So each contest, I learned a lot of things.
A lot of things.
And I become more and more confident today.
Confident.
Yeah. So it is my memorable experience in my life, I should say.
So
and there were a lot of hurdles also in each contest because we have to do ourselves everything.
Competition, how
yeah.
was it?
I made nice friends, so I got Friendship Award in Mrs. Globe.
Okay.
Because I made a lot of friends there
friends
and
there.
I'm what I am. I am not, I can't, like how I am, I'll be the same. So I won't act different in front or back, it's like that for me.
Okay.
So I'm very happy that I was justified. For friendship.
Uh-huh.
Because I'm very a social person and so that was a very great moment for me.
Winning the beauty contest got you recognition.
Yeah, that's true.
So you're happy?
Yeah, I'm very happy.
Very happy.
And from here I can go ahead and achieve my other dreams also.
Other dreams also.
Like, as you said, social work.
Yeah.
Then maybe I can guide few girls who want to take part in Mrs. India or Mrs. World contest. I can guide them. So I'll be very happy to do that. So on this platform, I want to say that.
So you want to
help them
help
in whichever
them.
Way I can.
Can.
I'll be very happy to do that.
Do that.
Because I know what difficulties I have gone through when there's nobody to help you.
Yeah. Okay.
So
you, help. When you took the decision, it was an instant decision and it was
Mrs. Karnataka, yes.
Yeah. And
but
you took
from there
challenge.
Was no looking back.
No looking back.
Yeah.
You took it as a challenge.
Yeah.
So, today, if you want to say something like
girls.
To girls, what happens now? Once they have a child, means
yeah.
once they have reached a certain age, they say,
yes,
oh, you know,
I'm done with it.
Done
with
it.
That's true.
So, health wise, means now they are getting conscious.
Yeah.
But most of them say,
Yeah,
so want to say something to them.
Yeah, there I think women should never feel that is end of their life. Marriage is end of their life. First
uh-huh.
thing is that they should always keep learning, growing in their life. That's what I feel, and they should never stop dreaming. So marriage is not end of anything. It's gives you more opportunities. I feel after marriage, you should not stop thinking that marriage is done. So I'm done with my life. So whenever the opportunity comes, they should take it up as a challenge and do it.
Do it.
Yeah. There's no end for challenges. There's no end for opportunities. It's like living your dream every day.
So it is never too late to begin.
Field. I'm not talking about beauty pageant.
Yeah.
I'm telling about any field. It can be a working woman with their dreams of becoming a CA. Yeah. Can be anything.
So
it's not a beauty pageant only that they should think of.
Never too late to start anything.
They can start as an entrepreneur somewhere.
Okay.
Yeah, they can start, if they like singing, they can become a singer.
Singer.
Dancing, they can become a dancer. Whatever. Whatever they like. It's not only beauty pageant.
There should be passion
yeah,
to do
that,
something.
Yeah.
And age is just a number.
Just a number, yes.
Yeah?
That's true. So,
from Mrs. Karnataka to Mrs. Globe, state, national and international beauty contest, within a year, this achievement actually is like a crown which is placed on her, all her achievements. Gayathri, today, youngsters, even for small things, when they fail, they behave as if some world has fallen down
yeah.
and they are not able to cope up with it. So, can you give some suggestions, something you want to tell to girls, how to deal with failures?
I think failure is part and parcel of everybody's life. even the big, I think the big names, they have also seen failures in their life. It's not that failures are only restricted to some people in life. Everybody sees failures in their life. But our challenge should be that we should face it and come up in life. We should not get disheartened any part of their life. See, I also had failures in my life so many times. I felt, oh, I'm not doing the right thing. Why did I take this part in this pageant? Because I had to prepare everything on my own. And there was no support sometimes. But I said, no, I will take it as a challenge and go ahead and do this pageant and take part in this beauty show and come out with flying colors. So every girl, I think my message would be that they should face the difficulty and not give up. And there are so many ways they can talk to their parents, they can talk to their friends for help. And
so
the teachers are there.
There is nothing ashamed to be a failure.
Failure, yeah. I think even the biggest personalities, they have also failed in their life.
Uh-huh.
And they've then come up. So there's nothing like, oh, you failed, then you cannot do it again. I think you should take it failure as a good sense.
Hmm.
And teaches you a lot of things like how...
failure teaches you
more than
the
success. Sometimes. Because like if you get cheated in your life, sometimes then you know that you will be more careful. That you don't get cheated again.
Mm.
So something like that, failure is part and parcel of everybody's life. So you should not get disheartened. And if you feel, you should talk to your parents or family or teachers.
To the kids, no.
Yeah.
This point very important.
Very important, yeah.
When they fail, they don't want to discuss.
They feel
something.
Very confined. That is very wrong.
They should share.
And even parents, I will advise that they should be more like a friend to them. Instead of scolding them always or saying that you're not done it wrong, you did it wrong and all that. They should talk to them as a friend instead of scolding them always. So that they will also come openly and talk to them and share with them. So that's very important to parents also. They should act like a friend with them more than a parent.
So when there is a failure, it should be treated as a stepping stone to
success.
Success,
always.
Always. You should not get disheartened.
Yeah, not get disheartened and give it up.
Give it up. Never give up.
Never give up.
Never give up.
Yeah.
Never give up. This was Gayathri's message to young girls. Gayathri herself has told you she failed multiple times. Look at her. Today she has achieved so much. Gayathri?
Yeah.
Your role models in life?
There have been different role models in my life in different stages. But I look up on my mother actually. Because after my dad passed away, everything came upon her. She had to take care of finances and my marriage and everything on her. So she dealt with so nicely. She didn't make us feel any time any financial constraints are there, anything. She supported us so well and she took care of finance so well. She is not so educated, but still she took care of it so well. And manage the finance. Even today, I take advice from her for finance, where to invest, what to do. She is able to give me more advice than even a financial consultant.
So, when your father passed away, your mother took the entire responsibility and
gave us the best in life.
So, your role model.
She never felt anything, and so I inspired her because she is very hardworking, first of all, and she is not at all showing any disappointment. Like she didn't give up. Anything like she never gave up, like saying that my husband is not there, what will I do now? Everything has come on me. Nothing, she never showed even one day like that. She took as a challenge and took care of us so well. So she is my role model today because
today, when she sees you,
she's so happy. And happy. When I see her, I have still to learn so many things still, because every day she is teaching me something new.
When I hear you, Gayathri. That word actually again comes back to my mind. First thing we learn or say prayers, it is always begins with Matru Deva Bhava. And your mother
has
been your role model. And she has inspired you.
Yes.
And
she is so hardworking and she is so committed and all that. So I have learned a lot from her.
We can say something.
And even she is guiding my son also today.
Today.
More than me, she is guiding him better.
Better.
She is teaching him discipline, teaching him to. And she even helps him to in Kannada because I don't know Kannada much. So she helps him in studies.
Studies.
In Kannada, and he's scored full marks.
Full marks.
In Kannada.
Okay.
So she is like all rounder, I should say. Even she knows stitching, she knows, she's the very best cook. I think she cooks so well. And she is all rounder, I should say. She sings well.
She sings well.
She cooks well. She stitches. She is able to manage finance.
Hmm.
So it is like so many things I can learn from her even today.
Want to say something?
Now she's
to
not
mom?
Educated.
Sweet.
Mom, I love you so much and thank you for making me what I am today. Thank you so much.
Three, your future plans.
Right now, I get called for being a special judge in beauty pageants, and I also go for launches and also go for social events. But my future plan would be to help the girls who want to take part in beauty pageants in whichever way I can. I'll be very happy to help them, because they sometimes they don't know where to look for help or anything. So I'm able to guide them, I'll be very happy. And also I want to spend my time with Andhra Pradesh. That is also my future plan. And not even financially, but spend more time
more
with them. That
more
will
time.
Be my one of my mottos in life.
So for future,
little social work.
Little social work. And also
you
want to guide
young
girls
who want to take part in
beauty
pageants and
pageants.
Guide them accordingly.
Beauty
so
contest.
That is my
future plans.
And of course my son 10th is there,
board exam.
So my responsibility is there
first
importance. So I think next year it will be a little difficult for me to give more time to other things. I need to be focused on his future also. so that is my priority first.
As the time passes.
Yeah.
When
so board exams.
Board
so
exams.
I'm helping him to prepare for that.
Uh-huh.
So I sit with him and spend time with him in his education. I only guide him. He doesn't go for tuitions much.
Oh.
So
oh.
I am the only one who's teaching him
teaching.
At home.
Okay.
So I want him to come up
academically.
Also. Yes.
Very
so
good.
I want to help him in. I think the family support is the best support for any child.
Any child, especially
so,
yeah,
I need to be
when
there.
Board exams
yeah,
happen.
Board exams,
there's a lot of tension. There's
yeah,
a lot of pressure, stress.
So I can see it now itself. He's a
ninth,
so I need to be there for him.
So in future, you want to help girls who are to go
participate
in beauty pageants?
Beauty pageants or and underprivileged
kids.
I like to spend time with them.
God bless you for
thank
both.
Thank you, sir.
Today, I interview a beauty queen, and all girls will be expecting you to give a few beauty tips.
So I think inner beauty is more important than outer beauty.
Mm-hmm.
So a person if he is beautiful from inside also looks beautiful from outside.
Uh-huh.
It's not just saying because it's a general thing, but I feel myself. When I'm happy it shows on my face, when I'm sad it shows on my face. So each individual is like that. So I don't feel that beautiful means only looking good. It should be a good hearted person also. That's what I like most of a person. And beauty tips, drink a lot of water, exercise every day, and use less chemicals.
Chemicals.
So that is three things which is very important.
Very important
to look good. And when you are happy inside, it shows on your face.
Face.
So always carry a smile with you wherever you go. Don't show your sadness or anger to somebody else. That is really bad.
Mm-hmm.
So always keep smiling and think positive.
Think positive.
That helps you a lot.
Lot.
Yeah.
These are the beauty tips you want to give.
And I think we should always give happiness to others, and that gives you more happy. Like you feel more happy about it, and you look good.
Look good.
And do
the
good.
Beauty
don't take negative. Towards
anyone. Avoid
negativity.
Be positive.
Yeah. So that will give you more beauty
more
in your
beauty.
Life. Yeah. And make your life beautiful.
The inner beauty also shows outside
of a person.
Of a person.
Any 100%.
Right? Along with that, drink a lot of water.
Water, exercise.
Maintain exercise. A
diet, proper
diet.
Diet
right.
And avoid chemicals.
Avoid chemicals.
On the face and all that. So go for natural remedies at
remedies.
Home,
uh-huh.
whatever possible. Avoid chemicals on your face.
Chemicals on face. Okay. So girls, from Mrs. World, simple beauty tips. Can follow. Gayathri, your message to youngsters watching you.
I would like to say that live your dreams, don't give up any time of your life, and think positive, be positive. And suicide is not the end of the world. I think many youngsters are doing that. I read in paper, I feel so disheartened because small thing, they don't get good marks in college, they go and commit suicide. So that is not, if they're not good in education, they can do something else and live their life. It's not the end of everything. So don't ever get disheartened. Be positive and share your sorrows and whatever you are facing with your parents first, or your friends or teachers or whatever, and see what solution can come out of it. If a child is not studying well, it's not, doesn't mean that he is his life is ended or whatever, but he should think in other ways which way he can do better in his life.
So their parents' support is also
Important, and don't be disheartened for small things like not getting 90% or whatever. They can always do something else in their life. Maybe they are good in drawing, painting,
each
sports. So they should not give up in life.
Yeah, each individual is unique.
And don't take impulsive decision,
like
committing suicide or whatever. It's really hurting the sentiments of your parents first.
Yeah.
So don't do that. That's my message.
Yes. So each person has his own talent. Gayathri, you are telling, concentrate on the talent.
Yes.
Instead of concentrating on the
weakness,
drawbacks, weakness which have, concentrate on the talent and never give up. Don't get disheartened. Life goes on, and you should go along with life. This is
and
your
always
message.
Do good deeds.
Always good deeds.
Yeah.
So
it always come back to you.
So.
Yeah.
Dharmo rakshite rakshitaha.
Yes.
Yeah. So this is the message from Gayathri to youngsters. Thank you very much today for spending so much time with our channel and sharing your life journey from a girl from Delhi to winning Mrs. Globe friendship title at Las Vegas. It was wonderful meeting you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Ganapathy, for coming over to my place and helping me to relieve my moments again. So, and I'm also very happy that you are inspiring so many people, girls especially, to go forward and live their dreams. So if I could inspire somebody, I'll be very happy. And thanks to you and your team for spending the entire day with me. And it was really a memorable experience for me. I won't forget a long, long time to come. Thank you so much.
Namaste.
Namaste.